Well, there's been a great response to the cartoon workshops in this lockdown. Really inspired by all your drawings, all your cartoons. Absolutely brilliant. Really enjoying it myself. So let's get back into the non-mobile, mobile cartoon workshop and we'll get some more cartoons done. So we'll go back to the old drawing board and we'll see what we can draw today in 10 minutes, which you couldn't draw 10 minutes ago. Every day at 10 a.m. this week, I'm going to put a cartoon workshop. Today, we're going to learn how to draw a sheep in 10 minutes and be as silly as you like. So get your pens and your pencils ready and we'll get started. I'm just limbering up now. I'm not actually starting the cartoon. I'm just going to have a little warm up. It's like the cartoonist versions of press ups, doing the zeros and the M's, all the familiar sort of shapes that we're used to that you can use on your cartoon. What else we're going to be using? Like little triangles, it's like an A without the middle bit. We're going to use some lines with kind of blobs. Those are going to be joints for the knees of the sheep. Sheep knees are very attractive. We're going to have, that's a hoof, that's like an N shape. I'm going to put these all together in a way that makes up a cartoon. The famous U shape that we always use for noses, this time it's going to be the sort of nose of the sheep. It's going to be a lot bigger on the cartoon with all the O's and the M's and everything. So let's get yourself ready with your pens and your pencils and we'll start on the actual cartoon now. So I'm going to start as usual. And we'll change this up as we go along for different techniques, but for now we're just getting used to it. It's the O shape. That's a really bad O shape, but I'm going to keep with it anyway because it's going to look slightly different than any other sheep I've drawn. You should be the same. Don't worry if it's not the same as mine or exactly how you want. Just go with it. You can always try it again. So I'm doing that second O again. Not quite closing that gap, but I'm starting from about there. I'm going to do a big U shape, and this is going to be, it's like the person's nose that you draw, only a lot bigger. I mean, you can still make a person out of that with a huge nose, but this time we're turning it into an animal's nose, like the front of its face. Now here, for its nose, we're doing a V shape, because that's kind of our sheep's nose and mouth is set up. That's dead easy. You can just do like a Y shape, so you've got the letter Y there as the nose and the mouth. And I'm just putting this on the bottom as a lip. It's going to look quite funny. Again, do any size that you want. For the hair or the top of the head, it's a little bit woolly, needs a haircut like a lot of us, I would imagine. We're doing all these M shapes, stringing them all together. So we've got lots of M's lining up. And again, as big, if you do them bigger, it's going to look like a fluffier hair or wool. For the eye, again, the way we do eyes, we leave that little bit to make it look shiny and 3D. And if you want to make it look a little bit dopey or sleepy, then just put the line across. You leave that off if you want. Whichever you want to do, just make it your own. Okay, for the back of the sheep, we're doing M's. We're going the other way. It's a little bit tricky because we're kind of writing an M backwards. If you find it easier starting from the other end and working towards the head, do that. There's no absolute rules in this. We're just making our cartoons. The more you make it your own, the better. I'm just showing you some basic shapes. So now I've moved on to W's now. That's really tricky. Hope you can do that. Okay, so we get M's going as W's. They're all shapes that you're used to. And this is the tail at the back. Nothing too complicated. We just load a few more M's on there. Now for the ears, we're doing that triangle that we made earlier, but we'll start off just with one line on each side. So it looks like the sheep's got horns. Okay, but then on the end we make it turn down and just put a little oval on the end of there and just colour it in, and it just makes it look like it's got slightly floppy ears. again, makes it look a bit more silly, because the sillier the better with your cartoons. Back legs, they're sort of bending funny ways, sheep's legs, if you've ever studied a sheep's legs, which you probably haven't. So if you put a little line going down and a blob, that's its knee, its little joints. This leg goes the other way, because you've ever seen a sheep kneeling down, they always have the legs tucked under themselves. And then from the knee down, another little line, make it as thick or as thin as you want. And on the bottom of there, once I've done these, the one in the background is going to be a little bit shorter, because it's like the perspective you're looking at it, it's a little bit further back, so we make it a little bit shorter. Okay, then on the bottom we're going to have the hooves, which is really simple N shape. Put a little ankle on there if you want, like I'm doing, another little blob. And then on the bottom we're going to have another N shape, little half circle, an N shape, and just thicken those up a little bit if you want, once you've made that N shape. Great, now you should have something that's looking slightly like a really mad looking sheep, which is perfect. Now along the bottom, depends where you put this line, I'm going to do a little extra bit of tuition on this line, which is really important. It's simple, but it makes that sheep look like he's jumping, because his shadow is further down than the sheep, which gives the impression that that sheep is actually jumping off the ground. So, you know, this is creating movement without altering your cartoon at all. If you want to add a bit more detail to the wool, a few letter C's overlapped makes it look a little bit more woolly. And if you want to get your pencil and do a little bit of shading just for the face, really, because we want to make the sheep's wool look really white, so you can just add little tiny bits of shading to that, and you can really make a lot more shading on the face to make it look a different color than the actual wool. And again, if you've got colored pencils, you can do that as well. I'm doing little lines here just to make it look like he's got a little bit of movement going on, like he's actually jumping. All these little details, so he's jumping up and down, all just because that line's a little bit lower. That's all it is, that line, that makes the difference. So I'm going to do a little bit more on that line and show you how it makes a difference. So I've drawn four sheep. Don't you try and suddenly scribble these down, just watch what I'm doing. And you can do this when you draw your sheep again. You can do it slightly differently, but just watch what I'm doing for now. You've already got your sheep drawn, but once you've drawn it a couple of times, maybe you're drawing yourself a little flock, you can do this as well. So my first line, it stood on the ground, this sheep. I'm adding a little few tufts of that represent grass. They look a bit more like grass, so it give it a bit more detail again. So that sheep is stood on the ground. This sheep is going to be slightly off the ground. I'm creating movement in my cartoon without actually changing the drawing. And that one looks like it's jumping a little bit, with some bit more movement going on. All these are pretty much the same, these cartoons. The only thing that's changed is that line, but it gives it movement without actually going to too much effort. So I'm going to make this one a little bit further off the ground, I think. I'll try and get a little bit closer so you can see what I'm doing. So even further down with this line now, and a few more tufts. So he's in a field, just gives you that impression of the sheep being in a field. Okay, and just one more time, I'll make this even lower. So it's jumping even higher, again without making any changes to the sheep, only we can fit some little lines underneath there. And maybe because it's doing so much exercise in the lockdown, it's actually sweating a little bit, so we put some little drips there as well. And some more lines. So when you draw your sheep next, you can decide whether it's jumping, standing still, or whatever. You can change it, you can change the ears, you can make them go straight if you like, so because it's jumping up and down. I'm going to show you a really simple animation in the next couple of days as well. You can actually animate just with a piece of paper, it's really good. So now you've got all these to look at, you can try and draw your own alter your sheet. This is actually a really bad sheep if you look at it. You know, I've made a mess of that one really, there's lines all over the place. So I'm changing its expression, I've given it a little, cross eyebrows. I'm going to give this one some eyelashes, make it look a little bit prettier. And you can just have a little mess around with the different things, a little smile there. You can alter these very, very simply. That's what it's, that one's got its bottom lip sticking out. And this one, I'm just going to be his tongue sticking out. And my pen's being a bit dodgy. That is actually a rubbish tongue. So I'm going to draw another one. Not done a very good job of that. But we all go wrong. You'll be going wrong. There's a tongue. That's more like it. It's like a U shape with a little line down the middle. It looks like a tongue. You can colour that in pink with your pencils or your felt tips if you've got one. But just have a play. Alter them. Give them their own personalities. And you can put all little bits in the background, which I'll be showing you how to draw things for the background. We've got a little collection of things. Because I made such a mess of that, I'm going to make that into something else. I'm going to do a few little M's and a couple of ears. And it's like a little sheep giving it a kiss. Which is very cute, but the sheep doesn't look too thrilled about it, to be honest. It looks a little bit annoyed. So that's a really sad scene, isn't it? That's sad to see. A little sheep trying to kiss the big sheep, and the sheep's kicking off a little bit there. But that's the good thing about cartoons, you can make anything happen. So it's all down to your imagination, really. So have a look at that, and when you draw your sheep next, have a little go at this. I bet your sheep's better than mine. So send it in, let me have a look, and we'll see what alterations you've made. If you made it look sillier than mine and added all your little bits and pieces to it. So keep practicing, and here's a little cloud, a dead easy cloud to show you. Straight line, a few M's of different sizes, big ones, little ones, little curves, and you got a cloud. It's very much like a sheep, but without a head or anything. So let's see what you come up with. Don't forget to subscribe to the Cookie Cartoonery channel, and we'll be giving out prizes for all your efforts. Don't forget to send them in. Thanks for all your support, and see you next time.